I'm 22 years old and I'm training for the NFL.
And you moved to Norwalk, and how many brothers do you have? Like, tell me a little bit about your family.
Well, I have four brothers, and then I have two sisters. One adopted, one adopted sister, one adopted brother. One of my brothers is autistic, so, you know.
Did you ever have to play a role of, like, you know, taking care of them or doing that with school or all that?
Well, yeah, when my parents aren't around, because my dad worked, he drove trucks, so, you know. And so just the times he was gone, you know, I felt like I had to step up, be more mature for my family and my brother and my sister. So when he wasn't around, you know, it was just times that I felt like I had to step up and be a role model for my family.
Tell me a little bit about high school. Like,
growing up, I played baseball. I played baseball my whole life. And then actually when I got to high school, you know, my older brother, he started playing football. So then I kind of like looked up to him. He was good at it. So I saw him like becoming great and looking at all the accolades. He was playing football, and I know. And then when I saw that, I kind of figured I wanted to do the same thing. So, I started playing my freshman year, and then I followed my big brother's footsteps to continue to play football.
And did you guys have a lot of your parents' support?
Yeah, we had a lot of support from, you know, friends, family, just extended family, so, yeah.
And then, so in high school, you started your freshman year?
I started my freshman year for my coach. He actually lived down the street from Moreno. Yeah. I started with him. It was crazy because when I first started, he would call me like every day just to try to get me out on the field.
Did you think that happened?
Like,
junior high school, after high school?
The feeling of when I scored my first touchdown and how good it felt, just because I watched football my whole life, and you know, a couple of my favorite players that were actually running back. So when I scored my first touchdown ever in football, then that's when I knew like this is what I wanted to do. Like, the head coach at Wong-Rivera, his name is Bobcats Penny. He coached at a lot of big time Division I programs. He coached in the NFL for 5 years. And he coached a lot of my favorite running backs that I actually grew up watching. So when he first came to recruit me, and as a head coach, when a head coach comes down to see you, that's something big for a student athlete. So once he came down, I met eye to eye with him. You know, I felt I had a good vibe with him. And you know, he has a great offense he runs.
Now that you're Division I, you already finished your college years, what do you have to do now in order to make it?
Definitely just being myself, stay committed to what I'm doing, staying disciplined with just everything that I have to do, you know, whether it's eating right, going to my workouts daily, taking care of my body, just little things like that, just to prepare myself to become a professional, not just a collegiate athlete, but just the transition from going from an amateur athlete to a professional is just, it's just different, and those are the things I gotta continue to work on.
Are there people helping you to do that, or like a coach or something?
Yeah, my trainer and then my agent. He just reminds me daily, like, this is your job now. This is what you this is what you wanted, you know, your whole life. So he just reminds me daily, you know, just be a professional. You know, don't you know you can't do certain things that other kids are doing at your age. You know, you got rules to follow. So, you know, you can't be out doing certain things that other kids can do. You can't, you know, it's just a lot of things you can't do. You just really learn how to become a professional.
You sort of have to calm down your social life.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Is that difficult? Like, I mean, you're young, so, and I'm sure you have friends that, mm-hmm. you know, weekends are telling you, hey, let's go out. You know, what do? Like, do you actually go out, or do you just kind of stay focused, or how do you balance that?
I really don't have a hard time of staying disciplined and just being myself. So really, I try to enjoy myself sometimes, like when I know I got time to, when I feel like I had a good, you know, week of workouts or just something. I just feel like sometimes I deserve to go out, but you know, I just the people around me, they know what kind of path I'm on. So I don't hang out with people that like try to steer me in the wrong direction. So, you know, the people that I hang out with, they kind of know what's going on. So sometimes they won't even ask. And if they do, then they already know the answer themselves. Like, nah, you know.
Yeah. So actually, I
want
to ask you, how did you balance the whole, you know, student athlete? I mean, that's very difficult to keep your grades up and still, you know, train yourself to be a better football player every day. How did you balance that?
When I got to University of Idaho, I learned how to manage my time. So really what I did was I made a calendar like every month. So what I do is I write whatever I got to do down each day of the month. So like, on Monday mornings, what I did was I knew I had to work out at 6 o'clock, 6 a.m., so I'd be in bed about like 10, 11, the latest. So I knew I had to work out at 8 o'clock, so I put my, 6 o'clock, so my workout's at 6 o'clock. Then I knew I had to get something to eat at 7:30. Then 8 o'clock come, I had class. Then 9:15 come, I knew I had to go to study hall. So it was just, I made a schedule for myself, and I really just followed it my whole college career, so that helped me out a lot.
Good. So you actually planned out your meals as well?
Yeah, I planned out my meals as well. Yeah.
So is there anything that ever, challenged you to follow that plan?
It's a challenge every day. Yeah, it's a challenge every day. But when you want something, when you want to succeed, man, I feel like there's nothing really that can really challenge you and stop you from really getting to what you want to get. Well, my biggest thing is I try to learn as much as I can every day from anybody. Whether it's to my trainer, to a bum on the street, I feel like if you just listen and get advice from anybody that actually knows what they're talking about and feel like it's the right advice, then you'll be fine.
And so how do you feel now where you are in your life and knowing where you came from, Crenshaw? Many people that come from there, not everyone ends up where you are. So how does that feel for you?
You definitely feel accomplished because, especially when you look back and you see the same people doing the same thing where you grew up at, that's when you kind of know it's like you accomplished something because you moved out and you got on. And, you just see the people that you were with back then doing the same thing. So, I know that I accomplished a lot because, I graduated. I graduated school. I did a lot of community service. I accomplished some cool things on the field as well.
How do you improve yourself each day as an athlete? Do you, tell me a little bit about that.
Just improving yourself, just always listen and just try to get as much knowledge as you can from anyone. Don't bury yourself. And just whatever you're doing, just continue to give it 100%. Don't ever go halfway at what you're doing or halfway of, like, oh, I think I believe this guy, but I think I don't. Like, if you're going to choose someone, fully commit yourself to that person. Because if you're going 50-50, you'll never get the best of what you need in whatever field you're in.
And what motivates you to be a football player? Like, to do what you love? I mean, any other person or young adult that plays football in high school and, maybe are thinking, like, I don't have a chance in NFL. Like, what would you say to that? Like, what motivates you?
I mean, I'll just tell them, I grew up, I really wasn't into playing sports. I watched a lot of sports. So I was kind of like a chubby kid. I was just a kid that watched it, didn't think I could play it. So, I just if you feel like you got the ability to do something, then go for it. I feel like you shouldn't bury yourself at all. Even if you feel like it's impossible, you can just continue to grow, continue to get better.
So tell me a little bit about how you got involved with the
Dream Podcast. I was good friends with Miguel's brother, Ivan. He was like one of my best friends in middle school. And then high school was still cool and all that. And then my older brother played with Miguel. My older brother's senior year was Miguel's junior year. So, and then I eventually moved up on varsity after my brother left. And then Miguel was the quarterback and linebacker of our team. So, and then and then some things happened, and then it was fortunate. I feel like I was fortunate to play with somebody like him because, as a quarterback, he was everything you wanted in a quarterback. He was a genuine person, a caring person. He was a leader, and he was just one of the guys that everybody looked up to because he was a guy who worked hard and really didn't say much and just followed rules. So. I got involved with him like that, and then we just kind of been cool after that.
So football got you guys together. So when you heard about this accident, what were your initial reactions?
I remember I remember it like it was yesterday. We were in the weight room, and then our high school coach had mentioned it that he got into an accident. I was in school.
Okay.
So I really couldn't. I didn't know what to believe. I was shocked. Just like any other person. But
now that you saw that what he's doing, you know, to inspire young adults and just really, you know, get them to do something with their life, like, how, like, why did you choose to, you know, not only because he's your friend from football, but, like, do you, like, also feel like this message is very important to young adults?
Most definitely. Even if he wasn't my friend, and even if I met him on the streets and I just seen what he got going on, you know, I definitely get involved in, because this is something I actually want to do with my career when I'm done with you know, playing football. It's just to help inspire kids, you know, because that's what it's all about. I mean, and some days, like, and you probably don't even know this, but some days, like, I've seen a couple of his Instagram videos, and it's like, you know, as humans, everybody got days when they wake up, they, like, you know, they don't want to go to work, or they don't want to do something, and when you do that. But if you look at people like Miguel, who's, you know, not in a position as other people are in, and then you see what he's doing, I mean, that can motivate a lot of people. It motivates me to get up and go work. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not tired. I'm blessed. You know what I'm saying? I'm walking on 10 toes, 2 feet. So, you know, when I get up and when I see that, you know, it motivates me. So, you know, as kids out in the world today, in high school, middle school, whatever, you know, you just can't make excuses for yourself. You just got to, you know, continue to keep working.
Do you felt like he impacted your life in a way because of what happened? Not only because he was your friend, but, like, what happened to him is really, you were close to him, so you know that it could have impacted your life. Did that
definitely, yeah, because, you know, like I said, like, you know, I mean, if you go see somebody, you know, who's walking daily, you know what I'm saying, your quarterback that you play with, you know what I'm saying, stuff like that, people that you play with, and you see stuff like that, and you like, man.
Do you remember his, like, life before that?
Yeah. So I remember that like it was yesterday. So you going from somebody who's walking, chilling with you, you know what I'm saying? Some countless days in the summer, y'all putting work in together, and then you see him now, to where he's in a wheelchair, you're gonna feel some type of way about it. But what makes me feel good about it is that a lot of people in his shoes and his position would have gave up. You know, they wouldn't have, you know what I'm saying, like, just give up, like, I ain't, you know, I can't walk again, I won't do this again. But what I said about him earlier, a genuine person, you know, just, he was always a hard worker. That, you know, that drive and that motivation for football carried on to his everyday lifestyle to me, because, I mean, a lot of people in this position would have quit. They would have, you know, stopped. They wouldn't go to rehab and try to get right. They would have just sat on their tails and then just, you know, said, forget it. You know, I'm not going to, I can't walk. I ain't going to do it again.
Yeah. And so, what is it about the Dream Project that you admire the most?
I mean, just the name itself, Dream Big Project. I like it. It got a ring to it, a Dream Big Project. Like, you know, just especially, like, if you're coming from where I came from, like, you have to dream big.
What would you say to young adults that, you know, are struggling, like, as far as maybe, you know, they're doing drugs or they have family problems, whatever it is that with their personal life that's affecting them to actually go after their dreams, like, what would you say to those? What would you say to inspire and motivate those young adults?
I would definitely say that it's always someone who's doing, who got it worse than you, so, you know, you can't make excuses for anything, you know. As long as you right here, breathing, God allowing you, breathing, you on your feet, and stuff like that, you can't make excuses. Like, if you got the access to do something, you should go ahead and do it. You know, you shouldn't bury yourself just because you put in this, you know, this type of situation. And that's how I looked at it growing up, you know, just my life. You know, I went through a lot of challenges, you know, just growing up from where I was from. But I didn't let that, you know, just, it didn't, I didn't let it become the reason why I wasn't going to be successful.
So what sort of advice would you give to the high school football players that are right now, you know, their senior year or junior year, like, saying, like, I want to play college football, like, and chase and go after that dream that you are pursuing right now? Like, what sort of advice would you give them?
I would just tell them that, like, just fully dedicate yourself to it. Don't be 50-50 with it. Don't be like, all right, you know, this week I'm gonna work out hard. But the next week, it's like, all right, I'm gonna go out to the club, I'm gonna go to these parties, I'm gonna go out and have fun. If you're gonna do it 100%. Don't go halfway, because then you're gonna get halfway results.
So my last question is, who's the better player, your brothers? I know they all play football, so tell me a little bit about that. Like, who do you think the best players?
I'm gonna say me personally. But to be honest, athletically, that's probably Rashad. I don't know, it's kind of different. Then Breon's going to grow into being a good athlete. He's trying to figure his body out still because he got so tall within like a couple months. He's 14, so he got big. And I don't know, we all kind of different though. You know, Robert was a good athlete. You know, I'm a good athlete. I'm pretty fast and agile for my size. So, you know, that's kind of like freakish, like how big and fast I am. And then Rashad is just, I don't know, he do things that, you know, a lot of people can't do. I don't know, but I think I'm the best football player. It's me.
How many of us, how many jealous? Real friends, there's not many of us. We smile at each other, but how many honest?